Hey everyone, Craggy again, and this time he's popping up. I'm gonna do the second of the Takara United Beast Wars leader figures. Well, they're deluxe figures, but they were packaged in Voyager boxes and sold at a higher price point, and they're of the characters who were the leaders. So this one is Optimus Primal. More of an ape look there. Again, repaint of the Cybertron toy. I don't know if this one was used for the 10th anniversary Beast Wars or not. I wouldn't have been surprised if he wasn't, because he is Optimus Primal in this form at least, but he's very transmetally, maybe not transmetal, but he's very robotic. The Megatron had a little bit of that as well, but the purple was more in keeping with the show model. This guy, he's black on the sides, on the back, and on the legs, but there's a lot of grey going on, and blue, and he actually reminds me of a Pretender Beast, which is quite cool. It sort of fits with the idea that some of the comics have brought up where the pretenders are, or yeah, the pretender shell or pretender technology kind of gives way to the Beast Wars shell formers, which is quite a clever idea, and it makes me almost like the shell former guys a little bit more. Now he's a monkey and he is a bit smaller than the Megatron, but he also comes with this, which is, well, best to show you, a surfboard for a monkey, a hoverboard for a monkey. He's an ape, not a monkey, but he's a monkey. So reminiscent of the Transmetal Optimus Prime, where his two feet bits could join together to become a surfboard sort of dude, sort of thing. This one, he just has it as an extra. Now, transformation, it's not difficult, but it's not the easiest thing in the world. It's quite cool. You flip the panels open at the side here, and then the back panel comes up like this. Now, I always get confused when I'm doing this. Probably the best way to do it is to, I think, unclip the chest and the head, fold the head up, and then the back section flips up like this. Now, where do I do this? It's stuck in there, so what I'm going to do is, that's what it is. Fold that back and pull this out so that you can then fold this back up and fold this round. See, I always get confused. So you've got all his monkey on his back. Fold the legs down, feet forward. Bits on the front of the legs become the feet. And you've seen it also as well, when this is all done, the legs that were here have splayed out and these legs have squished in together. I really quite like that. Fold the chest back up and rotate it right the way down. And then just line up the arms and you can fold the little beast hands, folds around to become a, well, an anthropomorphized robot hand, I suppose. It leaves him with a bit of a backpack and a big butt, a bit of junk in the trunk. He transforms in from a gorilla into a mandrill, apparently. But he looks like Optimus Primal. He's pretty badass. Now, the one thing that I have noticed is on the pictures on the box, these bits and these bits, so the upper arms and the thighs are swapped around. I'm not sure if that's an error on the one that was photographed or an error on this one. I haven't tried popping the ball joints off and swapping the bits around, but you could probably do it. I like the way it works better with it all black at the top here, and the same in the beast mode. It just looks a little bit better, I think. There's more grey in the legs anyway, so I think it gives him a better overall sort of look. The bot mode, really quite nice. He's got this Matrix-esque sort of design on the chest, and he's got the blue and the grey coming out a bit more. He's got really cool head sculpt. That is not Optimus Prime, that is Optimus Primal, without a doubt. You're not going to focus, are you? Oh well. Big yellow eyes, which is nice. Ball joint, ball joint, ball joint. Bendy thing. No waist articulation, because that would be really too difficult with the transformation. Ball joint, ball joint, ball joint. And you can even give him a little bit of toe if you want to. Yeah, there is a maximal symbol locked away in here somewhere. I think it's right in here. There's not any way. You can just about almost make it out in there. It seems the most random place to put a faction symbol on any toy that I've got anytime recently. And it's not like he's got an Autobot symbol painted on his arse or something that you could say, oh well, that was a little Easter egg. There's no Autobot symbol. It's just he's just a Maximal, but you have to really, really want to find out. Surfboard, he can't stand on it anymore. What's he gonna do? Well, if you have a Cyber Planet Keen, plug it in there, or you can figure out where the thing is. Right, there's the clip. It pops open like this. There's a missile goes in the front, launches out, and now he's got a big thing which he can hold. And the way I like to have him hold it, it's not that way. There is a way to make it look like it's sort of a guitar, and like he's playing some kind of space musical instrument. There is a better way than that, that I have posed him before, but I can't be bothered right now. This is mostly just to make it feel more like you've got your money's worth, and as a guy that's not a fan of missile launching actions, it's okay. It's nice that he can ride on it when he's an ape. That's pretty cool. Other than that, when he's in bot mode, he's just in bot mode. I suppose if you have a weapon that has a peg on the side, you could plug that into there and give him the maracas, the two swords that he pulls out his back. You can give him this, or there's no really clip missiles or anything on, but you could probably figure something out if you really wanted him armed up. But I'm quite happy with my Optimus Primal being less of a warrior than a Optimus Prime, curiously given the names. But yeah, this guy, he's more of a hippie, he's more of a science bot, and he works out really quite cool. Lots and lots of detail molded in on here. Decent posability, fun, interesting transformation, even if it's a little bit tricky if you've not done it in a while, apparently. I recommend him.